Alright guys, out here at camp this morning, and I'm going to put together a new recipe today I got from a subscriber, and it's called Johnny Cakes.
Johnny Cakes.
Never tried it before, but it's basically like a bannock, but you use a little bit of cornmeal and pancake batter instead, and I'm going to fry it up in some bacon grease. So definitely not the healthiest breakfast, but it's something new that I want to try out, so I'm going to give it a go. Alright, so first things first, I gotta get some firewood gathered. Behind the camp I got all this dead standing wood that I kinda picked up from the area, and I can use that for the firewood. So I'm gonna start chopping that stuff up right now. I'm gonna build a little base for the fire. When I do cooking fires, I typically will cut up a bunch of pieces of wood to use as the base of the fire. That way it gives me a nice bed of coals. And I don't feel like setting up this whole buck saw, so I'm gonna use this little Bruk tip Silky I got. I think I just figured out. All right, if you don't have the ability to split wood, rounds don't burn as well as split pieces. With an axe, it's easy to split wood, but I think you can do the same with a saw. Just cut about halfway through, a third of the way through, like that. See it right there? And then hit it up against a tree. And I think it'll split. See, it's split. Now I have, instead of a round, I've got a split piece of wood. Tack! Wow, worked really good too. So yeah, just cut, do a little saw cut about a third of the way through the wood, and then gently hit it up against a tree, and you can get split wood without having an axe. Tack! Three pieces of split wood without an axe. Wood's pretty punky. So it was nice to have gloves to use when you're cooking over the fire. Keep me from burning myself. All right, just a couple pieces of bacon to get the grease I need to cook the bread. All right, so I did put a couple pieces of wood under just to get the frying pan up off the coals a little bit to help regulate the heat, because there's nothing worse than burning bacon. You guys have seen that a lot recently. I've been losing bacon, and I really am really sorry about that. So
I'm gonna try to do better this time.
Oh yeah, perfect. Slow and steady wins the race.
Ooh, that bacon ball. I like the little frying pan, but it's not big enough to put big pieces of bacon on. I'm gonna need to start bringing my grill out.
Oh man! Dang it! Why do I kill the bacon? Dang it! Dang it! Dropped a piece of bacon. Three things guaranteed in life: death, taxes, and ScrambledO dropping the bacon into the fire. I saved it though, and I will eat it. But anyways, here's the mix. This is the Johnny Cake mix. Like I said, it's pancake batter and yellow cornmeal. So it's probably way more than will fit in the frying pan, but I'll mix up the entire batter and then pour as much as I can into the frying pan. Forgot to record pouring the water in. I need to just get this mixed up as quick as possible. It looks like it's a little dry. So, go ahead and pour a little bit more in. Not much though. Actually, barely any. This looks really good actually. Mix it up good. Wow, this is like perfect, I think. So I pushed around the coals a little bit, just so I got a good base to cook on. And yeah, so it's time to put this batter in the grease. Right there. All right, there it is. It looks like I got enough grease to cook it. So I'm gonna let it go for another minute or two and then flip it and see what it looks like. You can kind of tell by the sound it makes when you scrape it against the bottom of the pan how cooked it is. That's how you turn it from medium to high. All right, I think it's good. Let's flip it. Oh yeah, look at that.
Look at that flavor.
Perfect.
Smells good.
Hopefully I got some maple syrup in my backpack. I kind of forgot to check before it came out. That looks pretty good to me.
Look at the golden brown.
All right, let's give it a bite. I did end up bringing some maple syrup out. It was just in my bag, so here it is. There's a little bit of maple syrup on it. Really good.
And I got bacon.
Mmm. What the heck is this thing? It's called a Johnny Cake. A subscriber mentioned it to me and then he emailed me and said, dude, you gotta try this out. It's called a Johnny cake. It's like a pancake, where you take half of the pancake batter out and replace it with cornmeal. I love cornbread. I know it's fried in bacon grease, so it's probably not the healthiest thing, but I've never been a big fan of bannock. It's just so bland. This right here is the missing link, cornmeal and bacon grease. Adding that maple syrup and that bacon grease and that cornmeal gives it a different texture and a different flavor. And boy, is it good. Really good. This is what I'll start carrying out into the woods rather than bannock. Halfway between bannock, it's like bannock, cornbread, pancakes. Really good. Not joking, not exaggerating. Here's a piece of bacon I dropped in the fire. Even these little crispities are good. See, what's cool about this is that you can eat it like bannock, like I'm doing, and just break chunks off of it. Or you could probably eat it like a pancake, and just smother it with syrup and eat it with a fork. You just break a little chunk off, pour a little syrup on it. Straight up drowned it. So, a couple things I picked up today. I learned that taking the frying pan about 2 inches off the coals really helps regulate the heat. You only need about 2 pieces of bacon to get the grease you need to make the Johnny cakes. And that chair I made at the camp is a big help already, saving my back. Next step is a sawhorse, finish up this roof, put another sidewall in. Great meal. This one actually turned out really good. So guys, thanks for watching. Until next time, ScrambledO signing off.